exercise 2.4, the last question, which is the last question of exercise 2.4 we will do today. And the question is, for the decimal expressions given below, decide whether this number is a rational or not. Okay, ये जो हमें नंबर दिए जाएंगे इसमें हमें देखना है कि ये रेशनल है या नहीं. If it is a rational number, then write your note about the prime factorization of denominator. अगर ये रेशनल नंबर है तो इनका जो डिनोमिनेटर है उसके prime factorization के बारे में आप बताएंगे. Okay, so let me see how to do these questions. First one, but before that I want to tell you that I have already told you about the decimal expansions. So three kinds of decimal expansions I had told. First one, it was terminating. Second, non-terminating, recurring or repeating. And third, non-terminating, non-repeating. Okay, so in this, terminating decimal is rational number, non-terminating, recurring also rational number, but non-terminating, non-recurring is irrational number. So this thing keep in the mind and then after concentrate on this question. First, 0.120, 1200, 1200, 1234 times 0 in such a way and so on. Okay, so first part is this. So look at here. First we will have to identify which kind of decimal expansion this we are observing, that it means it is endless, means non-terminating, and thereafter we have to concentrate here also. 1200, 1200, 1234 times 0 means digits are also not, block of digits are not repeating itself. So that means you can write, since block of digits are decimal expansion, therefore it is an irrational 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, clearly you can observe that which kind of decimal expansion it is. After decimal, the limited number of digits are there. Only 9 digits are there. So that means digits end here. Digits have khatam ho gaye. That means it has terminating decimal expansion. Okay. So you can write here. So in this prime factorization, it is the form of 2 raised to the power m and 5 raised to the power n. So understood everybody how to write, if how to identify that which is rational number, and if it is in rational number, then how can we write in the form of p upon q. I hope you understood nicely. So now third part, since it has not terminating repeating decimal expansion, therefore it is a rational number. Kyunki iska jo decimal expansion hai wo non terminating hai and not and block of digits are also repeating. So it is rational number. So now how to denote this is rational number? As in class 9 you have already studied how to denote, so let x is equals to 27.142857, 142857, and so on. Okay, this is equation first. Now, how many block of digits are repeating itself? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 3 and 3, 6. Total 3 digits are repeating itself. Six digits are repeating itself. So now we will have to multiply this equation by 10 raised to the power 6 into n. 10 raised to the power 6 into 27.142857, 142857, and so on. Okay. So now, when we multiply any number by 10, then decimal goes after one digit, ahead. And if we multiply any decimal number by 10, that decimal will move two digits. the same thing, if we multiply 10 raised to the power 6, then decimal will move 6 digits after. Means it will move 6 digits higher. In 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it will move here. Okay? So here we can write 10 raised to the power 6 into x. 10 raised to the power 6 also we can write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 into x. That is equal. Now this decimal will go 6 digit ahead. So 2, 7, 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7, 0.142857 and so. Okay. So now this equation we will write here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 into x is equal to 2, 7, 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7, 0.142857 and so. Okay. Now first equation on this x is equal to 27.142857 and 4. Now we have to subtract this equation from this equation. So minus 9, minus 9. So this minus 1, this is 1x. So what will come? Now, look at here. We will subtract this. So after decimal, the same number of digits are there. So it would be cancelled out. And here 7 minus 7, 0. 5 minus 2, 3. 8, 2, 4, 1, 7, 2. As it is. Okay, now 99,999 is multiplied by transposing, it will go on right hand side. So 2, 7, 1, 4, 2, 8, 3, 0 upon 27.142857, 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7, 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7, and so on. Okay, so we are observing that six digits after the decimal, it is repeating itself. So we have multiplied 10 raised to the power 6. Okay, 10 raised to the power 6 means this multiplied by x is equal to, and we know that 10 raised to the power 6, that means decimal will move 6 digits higher. So decimal this will move 6 digit ahead, and then after we have subtracted this equation from this equation. Okay, so what has come? 99,999, it is in multiply, it will move right hand side by transposing, so it is in divide. So now write in lowest form. So let me divide it by, I am observing 2 plus 7, 9, 9 and 1, 10, 10 and 4, 14, 14 and 2, 16, 16 and 8, 24, 24 and 3, 27 and 0, 27. 27 can divide by 9 and 9, 5 plus 45, 9 plus 9, 18, 18 and 9, 27, 27 and 9, 36 and 9, 45. 45 also divide by 9, so this whole number we can divide by 9. Okay, and here 9, 27, 0, 9, 1, 9, remaining 5, 52, 9, 5, 45, remaining 7, 78, 9 area, 72, remaining 6, 9 area, 63, and 0. So, it is in the form of P upon Q. So, it is rational number. So, I hope today you have understood nicely the last question of this chapter 2.4. What we have to do, some decimal numbers have been given to you and decimal expansion was given to you, and we will have to identify which kind of numbers are these rational number or irrational number. So we have seen these, if not terminating, non-repeating, that means it is irrational number, and if it is terminating, then rational number, and if not terminating, repeating, then also it is rational number. And how can we write in the form of P upon Q, we have seen. I hope you understand today all the questions nicely. So all the examples of these this chapter you will have to solve in your copy also, because in 10th class each example, each exercise is very important. So don't leave the examples, do each and every examples.